21, can you do some for me? Can you be under 21 for me? Hello, hello. Welcome to episode 2 of the Last Month Yesterday Show. Jeez, that was one long month. A part of me feels like it was 7 months. The really dumb and stupid part of me. My name is Armand Sarau, bringing you groundbreaking coverage of war, politics, and other very serious stuff. Speaking of other serious stuff, let's talk about the rap game. As we all know, the rap game is something that's on the minds of all of us intellectuals, constantly reverberating around in our heads. Unless you're Aubrey Drake Graham, then you've got other problems on your mind. But don't worry, they're pretty minor. Drake is a Canadian R&B rap artist, and the only people who don't know that are the unwanted sperm he's put into thick IG models. Out of his immense discography, he is famous for the songs One Dance, God's Plan, and Wagwan Delilah.
Wagwan Delilah, what's it like in Toronto City? I'm 2,000 kilometers away, but girl, tonight you look so bad, oh yes you do. Wagwan Delilah, no, I'm late cause there's bear traffic. I just showed my dog your Grammy, said he knows a man that slapped it. I'm so cheesed. And oh, if you're trying to hit it, look on the TD, RBC, Scotiabank, RBC, CIBC, PC Financial. Holla at me.
Ah, there's nothing more eloquent than the Toronto accent. To quote the famous words of Canadian founder Jacques Cartier, stop cheesing, fam! As much as I'd love to glaze this masterpiece, that's not the point of this episode. Drake has had much commercial success, but he's also been in the spotlight for all the wrong reasons. He's had feuds with several rappers throughout his career, including Kanye West, Pusha T, and the Red Teletubby. Honestly, he looks harmless. It's the green one I've got problems with. I don't like the way he's looking at me. Might have to throw a couple of hands and knock him out Diddy style. Poo, poo, poo. Most recently, Drake has been involved in a rap beef with another one of hip-hop's greatest MCs, Kendrick Lamar Duckworth. And let me tell you, this is not a guy you want to mess with.
You and Dad fighting over a beat.
I don't know if I've got hands like his. He's out there looking like my cat pushing a yarn ball. Wouldn't want to be on the other side of that. Kendrick has won multiple Grammys over his career, and he's become the poster child for the next generation of hip-hop artists coming from the hood. And no, I didn't just assume he's from the hood because he's black. I'm not Michelle Wu. Kendrick's discography is filled with tracks that are so artistically intricate and rich with meaning, such as Swimming Pools, How Much a Dollar Cost, and Humble. And then there are others, like this.
Hold on, let's get this shit, let's get this shit, let's get this shit, let's Top of the morning, 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 top of the morning. Hold on, let's get this shit, let's get this shit, let's get this shit, let's Top of the morning, top of the morning, top of the morning, top of the
I know Kendrick has won the award for Best Rap Album, but he also deserves an award for Most Aggressive Alarm Clock. It's so aggressive, he ranks just above The Rooster at 6 a.m. and Apple.
Not again.
Regardless of their quirks, Drake and Kendrick are at the top of the rap game, which is why all hip-hop fans were in for a treat when Kendrick dissed Drake on Like That, featuring on a track with Future and Metro Boomin. Kendrick single-handedly carried the album, so much so that the album title changed to We Don't Trust You, when it was originally supposed to be called We Don't Care, because nobody gives a shit about Future and his mumbo-jumbo delivery. Like, don't you have child support to be paying? In the track, Kendrick bashed Drake for certain claims he made on his song First Person Shooter with J. Cole. And let's just say that Kendrick was not happy.
These niggas talking out of their necks. Don't put no coughing out of your mouth. I'm way too paranoid for threats. Hey, let's get it, bro. D.O.T. the money, power, respect. The last one is better. Say yes, a lot of goofies with a check. I mean, yeah, get up with me. Fuck sneak dissing, first person shooter. I hope they came with three switches. I crash out like fuck rap. This Melly Mel if I had to. Got two T's with me. I'm snatching chains and burning tattoos. It's up. Lost too many soldiers not to play it safe. If he walk around with that stick, it ain't Andre 3K. Think I won't drop the location. I still got PTSD. Motherfuck the big three. Nigga, it's just big me. Nigga, boom.
Yeah, it's just big me. Or as I described Kyle Lowry, it's just big. Even though a lot of those shots were uncalled for, considering the fact that both J. Cole and Drake weren't even dissing, Kendrick definitely made a statement. Keep in mind, the last time Kendrick jumped on a song, Will Smith was still allowed at the Oscars. And just like Chris Rock, Drake did not keep Kendrick's wife's name out of his mouth. Shortly after, Drake responded with push-ups, channeling his inner Uma Thurman and taking down some of the biggest rap names in the game.
I could never be nobody number one fan. Your first number one, I had to put it in your hand. You pussies can't get booked outside America for Nan. I'm out in Tokyo because I'm big in Japan. I'm the hit maker y'all depend on. Backstage in my city, it was friend zone. You won't ever take no chain off of us. How the fuck you big stepping with a size 7 man's on? Cool, your last one brick, you really not on shit. They make excuses for you because they hate to see me lit. Pull your contract because we got to see the split. The way you doing splits, bitch, your pants might rip. Maroon 5 need a verse, you better make it witty. Then we need a verse for the Swifties. Top say drop, you better drop and give them 50. Pip squeak, pipe down, you ain't in no big three. SZA got you wiped down, Travis got you wiped down, Savage got you wiped down. Like your label, boy, you in a scope right now. And you gon' feel the aftermath of what I write down. I'm at the top of the mountain, so you tight now. Just to have this talk with your ass, I had to hike down. Big difference between Mike then and Mike now. What the fuck is this, a 20v1, nigga? What's a prince to a king? He a son, nigga. Get more love in a city that you run, nigga. Metro, shut your whole ass up and make some drums, nigga.
Unlike Kendrick's shoeboxes, there's a lot to unpack here. First things first, I've got a lot to say about Metro Boomin, but I think it's necessary I convey it in a language he'd understand. Moving on to more important things. Drake makes several claims about Kendrick, stating that he only writes features for white artists like Taylor Swift and Maroon 5, and that he was exploited on numerous occasions by his previous producer, Anthony Tiffith, also known as Top Dog, which, by the way, would have made a great porn star name. Like, what the hell are you doing as a music producer? Drake claims that Top Dog robbed Kendrick of a percentage of his shares, stating how Top said you better drop and give me 50 like some push-ups, which was a reference to this video of Kendrick doing push-ups in what seems to be a children's park. And that actually makes sense, because he has the same height and shoe size of a 9-year-old. Moreover, Drake also said that rappers SZA, Travis Scott, and 21 Savage are all better than Kendrick, which is a bold claim considering that 21 Savage has a lyric that goes like this.
I'm sitting on the blitz. Live on the toilet, I stay on my shit.
Live on the toilet, I stay on my shit. And just wait, that's not the only one.
What you smoking? Uncle Snoop. It smell like gas. I think somebody pooped.
You're telling me this man has won a Grammy? It seems like he hasn't even made it past the third grade. Wow, now that's disrespectful, Drake. But not as disrespectful as his next diss track that he dropped, called Taylor Made Freestyle. And as the title suggests, the song really proves their bad blood.
Kendrick, we need ya, the West Coast savior. Ain't Grady your name, it's some hip hop history. If you deal with this viciously, you seem a little nervous about all the publicity. Fuck this Canadian light skinned doc. We need to know the baby West Coast victory, man. Call him a bitch for me. Talk about him liking young girls, that's a kid for me.
Yes, you. What the fuck you really got to do? Passed you the torch at the House of Blues, and now you gotta do some dirty work. You know how to move, right? Right? I know you never been to jail, orange jumpsuits and shower shoes. Never shot nobody, never stabbed nobody, never did nothing violent. And no one, it's the homies that empower you. But still, you gotta show this fucking aisle who's boss on the West.
Yeah, that's the truth. I'm definitely about to come around the land gang and let my fucking bowel move. Shitting on you niggas from a whole different altitude.
Seriously, what the hell is it with these shit bars? Are we sure this isn't R. Kelly? But if you didn't already notice, most of this song is AI generated, including features from Tupac, Kendrick's Icon, and Snoop Dogg. Yeah, I'm certain you found it hard to tell. Well, guess what? So did Snoop.
They did what? When? How? Are you sure? Y'all have a good night. And to all. Why off? Everybody calling my phone, blowing me up. What happened? What's going on? I'm going back to bed. Good night.
He was so flabbergasted. He was like, let me do something else other than destroy my lungs on a daily basis. But as Drake urged Kendrick to drop, Drake was unfortunately the one who had to drop the song from social media, seeing that Tupac's estate threatened to sue him. There was no way Tupac was letting Drake have a better diss track than him. Besides, he didn't even hit him up. And after a week or so of waiting, Kendrick finally dropped a response titled Euphoria. And wait, this track is 6 minutes? Oh, we better strap in for this one.
Them superpowers get neutralized. I can only watch in silence. The famous actor we once knew is looking paranoid and now spiraling. You're moving just like a degenerate. Every antic is feeling distasteful. I calculate you're not as calculated. I can even predict your angle. Fabricating stories on the family front, cause you heard Mr. Morale. A pathetic master manipulator. I can smell the tails on you now. You're not a rap artist, you're a scam artist with the hopes of being accepted. Tommy Hilfiger stood out, but FUBU never had been your collection. I make music that electrify 'em. You make music that pacify 'em. I can double down on that line, but spare you this time. That's random acts of kindness. Know you're a master manipulator and habitual liar too. But don't tell no lie about me, and I won't tell truths about you.
Have you ever played? Have you ever? Okay, nigga, let's play. Have you ever watch your enemy down like with a poker face? Have you ever paid 500,000 like to an open case? Well, I have, and I failed at both, but I came out straight. It's always been about love and hate. Now let me say I'm the biggest hater. I hate the way that you walk, the way that you talk. I hate the way that you dress. I hate the way that you sneak this. If I catch flight, it's gonna be direct. We hate the bitches you fuck, cause they confuse themselves with real women. Then notice I said we. It's not just me. I'm what the culture feeling. I hate the way that you walk, the way that you talk. I hate the way that you dress. Surprised you wanted that feature request. You know that we got some shit to address. I even hate when you say the word nigga, but that's just me, I guess. Some shit just cringeworthy. Ain't even gotta be deep, I guess. Try cease and desist on I like that record. Oh what, you ain't like that record? Back to back, I like that record. I'ma get back to that for the record. Hey, fuck y'all niggas, I don't trust y'all niggas. I wave one finger and thump y'all niggas like field goal punt y'all niggas. They punk y'all niggas. Nobody never took my food. Whoever that's fucking with them, fuck you niggas and fuck the industry too. If you take it there, I'm taking it further. Psst, that's something you don't wanna do.
Ooh. We don't wanna hear you say nigga no more. We don't wanna hear you say nigga no more.
Stop. Now that was euphoric. Forget about shit bars. I think I just shit myself. Let's discuss what we learned. First, Drake is white. And there's nothing you could say to convince me otherwise. Huh. No wonder he idolizes Michael Jackson. Also, Kendrick is a certified hater. Like, he really, really hates Drake. In fact, he kind of reminds me of this guy.
His hair, whack. His gear, whack. His jewelry, whack. His footsteps, whack. The way that he talks, whack. The way that he doesn't even like to smile, whack. Me, I'm tight as fuck.
Yeah. He's giving Kendrick without the money trees. But what's most intriguing is when Kendrick references Drake's song back to back, stating that he likes that record, and he's gonna get back to that for the record. And if you don't know what that means, Drake dropped back to back diss tracks on Meek Mill in 2015. Wait, does that mean Kendrick is dropping a
Yeah, there's it's survival. I think somebody lying, smell somebody lying, I don't see no fire.
Yeah, somebody's lying, I can see the vibes on act. Even he looking compromised, let's peel the layers back. Ain't no brownie points will beam your chest, harass an ant. Fucking with good people, make good people go to bed. Conspiracies about cash, dog, that's not even the leak. Find the jewels like cash, dog, I just need you to think. Elohim, KTW, know you can't sleep, these images trouble you. Know the wires in your circle should puzzle you. If you were street smart, then you would've caught that your entourage is only to hustle you. 100 niggas that you got on salary, and 20 of them want you as a casualty, and one of them is actually next to you, and two of them is practically tired of your lifestyle. The first opinions is not convincing, y'all need a new route. It's time that you look around on who's around you before you figure that you're not alone. Ask what Mike would do.
Whoa, 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 slow down, Kendrick. Be humble. Sit down. 48 hours after Euphoria, Kendrick drops 616 in LA, which is a reference to several of Drake's timestamp songs, as well as 616 referring to several things such as Tupac's birthday, Father's Day, and the amount of cash I have in my bank account. Thanks, Northeastern Housing. This diss track marks a critical inflection point in this beef. After Drake was being a little silly goose, playing around with AI, Kendrick uses this track to truly attack his character and the people around him. And along those lines, he makes a very, very bold claim.
Are you finally ready to play? Have you ever, let's see, have you ever thought that OVO is working for me?
Did you ever think that OVO was working for me? I know they call Kendrick the boogeyman, but damn. This whole time, there's been a mole in Drake's camp feeding Kendrick information. And if you don't think that's true, many sources say that the black Maybach glove in the song cover belongs to Drake. Really, Drizzy? A horse riding glove? Come to think of it, Drake really is the type of guy to say, "Giddy up, horsey," before he races to a castle filled with strippers. This beef is starting to get ugly. And if you think that's where it ends, that's the furthest thing from what was on Drake's mind. And just like that, at 11 p.m. on Star Wars Day, Drake dropped Family Matters, a 7-minute long music video on YouTube. No way! Does that mean I get to see Urkel again?
Maybe in this song, you shouldn't start by saying,
"Nigga, I said it, I know that you mad. I've emptied the clip over friendly or jabs. You mentioned my seed, now deal with his dad. I gotta go bad, I gotta go bad. You better have some paperwork or that shit fake tea. Can't be rapping by no ratting that we can't read. I mean, it's true, a nigga slime me for my AP. Just like how Metro nigga slime him for his main squeeze. Out here begging for attention, nigga, say please. Always rapping like you about to get the slaves free. You just acting like an activist, it's make-believe. Don't even go back to your hood and plant no money trees. Say you hate the girls I fuck, but what you really mean? I've been with black and white and everything that's in between. You the black messiah, wifing up a mixed queen. And hit vanilla cream to help out with your self-esteem. Why you never hold your son and tell him say cheese? We could have left the kids out of this, don't blame me. You a dog and you know it, you just play sweet. Your baby mama cash was always screaming, save me. You did it dirty all your life, you trying to make peace. I heard that one of them little kids might be day free. Don't make it day freeze. Cause if your GM is your BM secret BD, then this is all making plenty fucking sense to me. Me and Savage had the hoes dripping wet at shows, almost had to swim to it. K-Dot shit is only hitting hard when Baby King put his pen to it. Ross calling me the white boy and the shit kinda got a ring to it. Cause all these rappers waving white flags while the whole fucking club sing to it. Hey, Kendrick just opened his mouth. Someone go hand him a Grammy right now. Where's your uncle at? Cause I wanna talk to the man of the house. A cease and desist is for hoes. Can't listen to lies that come out of your mouth. You caught a Tupac estate and begged them to sue me and get that shit down. I'm losing perspective on beef. Boy went to send beat and I kill you for fun. Your daddy got robbed by Top. You stunning and Wayne like father like son. And clearly because of the boy, the honorable thing is to give me the loot. You right about fuck the big three. It's only Big D and it's video proof. Our son should go play at the park. Two light-skinned kids, this shit would be cute. Unless you don't wanna be seen with anyone that isn't blacker than you. Why did you move to New York? Is it cause you live in that bachelor life? Proposed in 2015, but don't wanna make her your actual wife. I'm guessing this wedding ain't happening right. Cause we know the girls that you actually like. The darkest secrets are coming to light. It's all on your face like what happened to Mike.
There's nowhere to hide, there's nowhere to hide, you know what I mean. They hired a crisis management team to clean up the fact that you beat on your queen. The picture you painted ain't what it seemed, you did.
I've fallen and I can't get up. Ugh.
Ugh. Ugh. This is too much. It's too much. I mean, where do I even begin? I thought Kendrick was the idyllic poster child of hip hop, but he's actually a wife beater? And his daughter is actually the child of his creative partner? Yeah, things are not gonna be all right. This beef has escalated insanely quickly. Like, how the hell do you go from haha, you have small shoes, to you are not the father. But surely this has to be it. This has to be the soul crusher. The Tyson sucker punch. The Randy Orton knockout. The Peyton Pritchard buzzer beater from half court to absolutely obliterate the Mavs in five. We're gonna have to wait another 2 weeks for Kendrick to respond. There's absolutely no way he...
Dear Adonis, I'm sorry that that man is your father, let me be honest. It takes a man to be a man, your dad is not responsive. I look at him and wish your grandpa would have wore a condom. I'm sorry that you gotta grow up and then stand behind him. Life is hard, I know, the challenges always go beat us home. Sometimes our parents make mistakes that affect us until we grown. And you're a good kid that need good leadership. Let me be your mentor, since your daddy don't teach you shit. Be proud of who you are. Your strength come from within. A lot of superstars, that's real. But your daddy ain't one of them. And you nothing like him. You'll carry yourself as king. Can't understand me right now. Just play this when you 18. Dear Sandra, your son got some habits. I hope you don't undermine them. Especially with all the girls that's hurt inside this climate. You a woman, so you know how it feels to be in alignment. With emotions, hoping a man can see you and not be blinded. Dear Dennis, you gave birth to a master manipulator. Even using you to prove who he is a huge favor. I think you should ask for more paper, and more paper, and more paper. I'm blaming you for all his gambling addictions. Psychopath intuition, the man that liked to play victim. You raised a horrible fucking person, the nerve of you, Dennis. Sandra, sit down. What I'm about to say is heavy. Now listen. Your son's a sick man with sick thoughts. I think niggas like him should die. Him and Weinstein should get fucked up in a cell for the rest of their life. He hates black women, hypersexualizing with kinks of a nympho fetish. Grew facial hair because he understood being a beard just fit him better. He got sex offenders on Hovio that he keep on a monthly allowance. And a child should never be compromised, and he keeping his child around him. And we gotta raise our daughters knowing there's predators like him lurking. Fuck a rap battle, he should die so all of these women can live with a purpose.
Dear baby girl, I'm sorry that your father not active inside your world. He don't commit to much but his music, yeah that's for sure. He a narcissist, misogynist, living inside his songs. Try to destroy families rather than taking care of his own. Should be teaching you timetables or watching Frozen with you. Or at your 11th birthday singing poems with you. Instead he being Turks paying for sex and popping perks. Examples that you don't deserve. Dear Aubrey, I know you probably thinking I wanted to crash your party. But truthfully, I don't have a hating bone in my body. This supposed to be a good exhibition within the game. But you fucked up the moment you called out my family's name.
You a body shamer. You go hide them baby mamas, ain't ya? You embarrassed of them. That's not right. That ain't how mama raised us. Take that mask off. I wanna see what's under them achievements. Why believe you? You never gave us nothing to believe in. Cause you lied about religious views. You lied about your surgery. You lied about your accent and your past tense, all is perjury. You lied about your ghost riders. You lied about your crew members, they all pussy. You lied on them, I know they all got you in them. You lied about your son, you lied about your daughter, huh? You lied about them other kids that's out there hoping that you come. You lied about the only artist that can offer you some help. Fuck a rap battle, this a long life battle with yourself.
I can't do this, man. I can't do this. Can we talk about something else? Can we talk about something else? Hey guys, welcome to the Last Month Yesterday show. In today's episode, we're gonna talk about the man who gave a jellyfish STDs. Wow, that must have stung, huh? All right, anything else we can talk about, guys? Anything else? Kendrick couldn't even wait an hour. An hour. To drop a song addressed to all members of his family about how Drake is a horrible person. including his 11-year-old daughter, since 2013? Well, now we know what he meant by started from the bottom. This is no longer a rap beef. This is war. This is pure vile hatred for a guy who has a cap that says Anita Max Win on it. I mean, who the hell would own something like that? And all of these allegations are just absurd. Drake is not a pedophile. He's the boy, the sex god, the lesbian. If he's really who Kendrick says he is, pull up the video proof, cause I don't buy it.
I touched down in 86, knew I was a man by the age of 6. I even fucked a girl that used to babysit. You got a baby Benz, you got some bad friends. High school pics, you was even bad then.
You was fucking night after night. I'll change your life. You ain't even know how to suck it right. I taught you right.
Oh no. Oh, he's feeling the teenage fever, alright. Kiki, do you love me? Are you riding? Oh, she's riding, alright. She's riding the bus to high school. We need a response, Drake. But not before Kendrick does his victory lap.
I see dead people.
Sometimes you gotta pop out and show niggas. Certified boogeyman, I'm the one that up to score with him. Walk him down whole time, I know he got some hoe in him. Pull on him, extort shit, bully the floor on him. Say Drake, I hear you like I'm young. You better not ever go to cell block one. To any bitch that talk to him and they in love, just make sure you hide your little sister from him. They tell me Chubb's the only one that get your hand-me-downs. And party at the party playing with his nose now. And Baka got a weird case, why is he around? Certified lover boys, certified pedophiles. Wop, 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 wop. Dot, fuck him up. Wop, 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 wop. I'ma do my stuff. Why you trolling like a bitch? Ain't you tired? Trying to strike a chord, and it's probably A minor. They not like us. 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 He a fan, he a fan, he a fan. He a fan, he a fan, he a freaky ass nigga, he a 69 god. Freaky ass nigga, he a 69 god. Hey, 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 run for your life. Hey, 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 run for your life. Freaky ass nigga, he a 69 god. Freaky ass nigga, he a 69 god. Hey, 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 run for your life. Hey, 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 run for
let
your life.
Let me say O-V-ho.
O-V-ho.
Say O-V-ho.
O-V-ho.
Then step this way, step that way. Then step this way, step that way.
This man Kendrick Lamar really went back to back to back to back. And apparently, he has 10 more songs on the way. Like, doesn't this guy have a family? Doesn't he have things to do like go grocery shopping, mow his lawn, pay his taxes? But no, he's out here dancing on Drake's dead body, calling him a 69 god. And just to rub salt in the wound, Not Like Us became the fastest rap song to surpass 100 million streams, surpassing God's Plan by Drake. Man, Kendrick really told Drake to get the hell back into Marvin's room whilst all of his best friends were dancing to the song. How could you do this to him, LeBron? This is why Derek White will always be my glorious king. But wait, Drake is not done yet. A couple of days later, he released The Heart Part 6, a play on Kendrick's The Heart series. Oh, this has got to be good. The greatest diss of all time. After all the allegations, what does he have to say for himself?
Pulitzer Prize winner is definitely spiraling. I got your fucking lines tapped, I swear that I'm dialed in. First I was arrested, so where's the proof of the trial then? Where's the paperwork of the cabinet is filed in?
1090 Jake would've took all the walls down. The streets would've had me hiding out in a small town. My Montreal connect stand up, not far down. The ones that you getting your stories from, they all clowns. You waited for this moment, overcome with the desperation. We plotted for a week and then we fed you the information. A daughter that's 11 years old, I bet he takes it. We thought about giving a fake name or a destination, but you so thirsty, you not concerned with investigation. Instead, you in that Venice studio, it's a celebration. You gotta learn to fact check things and be less impatient. Your fans are rejoicing, thinking this is my expiration. Even the picture you use, the jokes and the medication, the Maybach glove and the drug he uses for less inflation. Yeah. I'm not gonna lie, this shit was some good exercise. Like, it's good to get out, get the pen working. You would be a worthy competitor if I was really a predator and you weren't fucking lying to every blogger and editor, but it is what it is. You definitely got this shit burnt the fuck out, though. Like, you got 10 more records to drop. The one before the last one, we finessed you into telling a story that doesn't even exist. And then you go and drop the West Coast one to try and cover that up. I would like that one. That would be some shit I could dance to if you wasn't tripling down on some whole other bullshit. But, you know, at least your fans are getting some raps out of you. I'm happy I can motivate you, bring you back to the game, like, you know. But just let me know when we get into the facts. Everything in my shit is facts. Waiting on you to return the favor, like.
I mean, when you were saying you were expecting for someone to call you a pedophile, that kind of raises a lot of questions. Good thing is that we know that Drake does not have a daughter, because OVO was feeding Kendrick false information. Other than that, the song was pretty mid. Drake pretty much called him sick in the head for bashing him so much, and then he supposedly ended the war by saying he's done with this. He threw the towel, and that's pretty much all she wrote. Or should I say, they wrote for all of his ghostwriters. So now the big question. Who won the beef? And before you say Kendrick destroyed Drake, it's important to understand that both of their reputations have been impacted. Although there are allegations of Drake grooming minors, Kendrick never really responded to the claim that Dave Free is actually the father of his daughter, or the claim that he beats his wife. He has admitted to infidelity in the past, so there could be some truth to that. Either way, both rappers need to take some time away from each other and probably focus on more important things. Their health, their safety, and their kids. Let's just hope Drake doesn't get too close. If anything, J. Cole is the real winner here for avoiding all of this. So much so that we all forgot about that Grippy song that he did. No, I'm kidding. That was absolute dog shit, Cole. What the hell were you thinking? Forget might delete later. That's a must delete now. And that's been the Last Month Yesterday show. Hopefully you learned something about the rap game today. And if you think you're a bigger rap fan than me, comment down below how many times I referenced a song or album of either Drake or Kendrick. Go ahead, you won't do it. But you know what? I think I'm gonna have to move on from the big three. How about some Lil Wayne and Eminem? Those guys would never disappoint me.
I be grinding on them hoes like a half pipe. She say, "Don't you the shit, you need your ass wiped.
I'll shit on you. I'll shit on you."
That's it. I'm done. I'm moving on to country music. Fuck this.